Hello, I'm Matthew Connor. Today I'm going to review the new Mizuno MP20 MMC. Now, as you can see, it does have signs of technology, and it is their second generation MMC, and I was a fan of the MP18. So let's have a try with this first shot. I'm into a little bit of breeze. It feels like there's a bit of rain in the air as well, so I don't think this review will take too long. Right. Oh yes, that's a cracking strike, and it's a really strong ball flight. And just like the rest of the MP20 range, it has a soft copper plating and a protective nickel chrome finish to help with feel and feedback. So now I'm going to test, see how easy it is to shape the ball. I'm going to grab a ball from the Creative bag. What shot have I selected today? Oof, high draw. Seems to be on a roll of selecting the high draw, but it is one of my favourite shots, so we'll really try and work this one over. Find a decent light, that's good. Right, let's get this high moving right to left. Oh, that's another great strike. And there is movement, but maybe not quite as much as what I had hoped. Now this thin top line and this toe-styled head does give you the feeling you can work the ball easily. So now I'm going to check to see how forgiving the club head is. I'm going to place this tape on the face. I'm going to try and misstrike this one off the toe and then just see how it performs. Right, one off the toe. Oh yes. That was off the toe, and for a miss hit, that was a cracking flight. You can see where I've hit from. Now on the back of the club is a titanium muscle insert, and on the bottom a tungsten sole wedge, which helped to spread the weight to give the club extra forgiveness from off-centre hits. So now I'm going to hit a couple more. The wind's actually picking up, you can probably hear it on the mic. It's getting quite strong now, so I'm going to have a few more before I look at the data. Oh, I'm on a roll of good strikes today, and even into the wind, that's a really good flight. These irons have been designed and refined to give help in the 4-7 iron and to help with scoring in the 8 pitching wedge. There is 12 grams of tungsten in the toe of the longer irons to help with the launch in a compact head. And to help with scoring in the 8 pitching wedge, the sole is narrower and the titanium muscle is designed just for the short irons. So this wind's really picking up now. I'm going to finish with this last one. Let's finish with a good one. Oh, that's a perfect finish. And that's another cracking strike. And the ball flight is really good into this strong breeze now. So the set's available in 4-2 pitching wedge in right hand only. And just like the rest of the MP20 range, they do have more traditional lofts, so the pitching wedge is 46 degrees and the 6 iron is 28 degrees. So now I'm going to check the readings. Considering I had a strong headwind, just like I found with the MP20 muscle backs, they are surprisingly long. And as I found previously, the launch angle is a little higher and the spin rate is a little lower than my usual. And the difference between the toe shot and the good strike is 5 yards in distance. So now it's time for me to sum this iron up. And I suppose the question you need to ask, are they better than the MP18s? Yes, but I wouldn't swap it if I already played the MP18s. But if I was playing the MP59s or irons of similar era, then definitely, without a doubt, the MP20s will perform better. So if you've enjoyed my review, please give me some thumbs up, place some comments below. Thanks for watching.